This is Remix Report with your hosts, DJ JD and DJ J Spring. For the date of
November 17th, 2010.
Today's video brought to you by yourdjlogo.com. Get your new DJ logo today.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Remix Report, episode 119. It's Playlist Wednesday. I'm DJ JD.
I'm DJ J Spring, and today we are going to be talking about an all-time classic song, Poison by BBD.
Belle Biv DeVoe, for those who don't know.
That rhymed right there. So we're going to talk about, as usual, as we do on Wednesdays, we're going to talk about how we go into this and how we go out. And this is a song that has a lot of options, which is kind of surprising for a song that's 111 BPM. There's not usually a lot you can do with this, but this song, I mean, there's a lot of songs I don't feel bad playing after this. It just seems like there's so many options you can do with this.
Yeah, it's like the epitome of like the New Jack Swing old school sound, and just it has such a distinct intro with the drums that you can really play it after just about anything. It just like it announces its arrival pretty much as good as any song possibly can.
Because you can play this after some of those, like, first of all, you can just drop the song very easily. You can play this after, like, some old-school hip-hop, like, even after Mo Money, Mo Problems, or This Is How We Do It, those kind of songs. And you could, like, follow this up with, I won't feel bad playing, like, some disco after this, if I wanted to go into that, or some, like, MJ or Prince. Like, I just feel like there's so many different kind of genres you could do after this track.
Yeah. And my example, I'm going to start with Crowd Motivator, Kukan Klan, Classic Party Break, Let Me See Those Hands, going into Poison. I did an edit of Poison, that I believe is on DMS, and I'm going to go into Motown Philly, another chorus edit that I did, that should also be on DMS as well, and, it kind of keeps that old school flavor the whole way, and Poison in the Motown Philly has always worked really well for me. So, why don't we take a listen to that?
Let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see them, come on, let me see those hands, come on, come on, come on.
So that was my example. I actually mix out at two different parts. Sometimes I'll mix out right after the first chorus, before the verse, depending on the crowd. If it's an older crowd and they're really into it, which, I mean, they usually are. You can pretty much play this for a young or old crowd. Everybody likes it. Sometimes I'll wait until after the verse to mix out, but it really depends on how quick I'm trying to mix. So those are the different ways I do it.
I usually mix out of this. I actually let this play for a little while for the most part because I like to mix out. I'm not sure which member of BBD does this part, but it's the one that ends with me and the crew used to do it.
Yeah.
Do you know? You have no idea.
Right? I have no idea, but that's where I mix out a lot of times.
Because right when that guy comes in, he actually does his little thing for 8 bars, so it's perfect to drop a track with the intro right when he starts. And the me and the crew used to do her part kind of is like that couple bars is a cappella almost. So it sounds good when the next song hits. And one thing I like to do, especially towards the end of the night, if I'm playing this, which is usually where I tend to play Poisons toward the end. If I haven't played all the MJ songs before it, then I'll drop It Takes MJ by Seraphine after this. So let's take a little listen to that.
You'll fall in love and you'll be screaming.
Big fellow like to vote, getting paid late, so better lay low, scheming on hot money in the whole show. The low throw hoe should be cut like an afro. So what you saying, huh? She's winning with you, but I know she's losing. How did you know? Me and the crew used to do her.
Come on, come on,
check it out, check it out.
So that was my example of how to mix out a poison. We know that you guys all play this track, so please let us know how you play it, what you play after it, because like we said, there's so many options you can do with this. We want to hear what you guys are doing.
Yeah, it's really one of those classics you can always go to that works just about every time.
And so it kind of reminds me almost of Push It, because it still gets that crazy crowd reaction when you drop
exactly, it. Exactly. So yeah, of course, let us know how you play it. Register, leave a comment.
Or email us, remixreport@gmail.com. Later.
Remixreport.com.